Hey guys, guess what I'm playing today? Sonic the Hedgehog 1. That's right, the first game. Wish me luck. This is actually the Japanese version of the game. If you didn't know, on Sonic Mega Collection, the version of Sonic 1 that you play by default is the Japanese version, which fixed the double spike invincibility glitch. You know, when you get hit by spikes, and then you land back on spikes, you're not actually supposed to die. Yeah, if you noticed on the Genesis version, when that happens, you do indeed die when you get hit by spikes twice, when you're normally supposed to be invincible. Well, that's fixed in this version. And later on, in the Labyrinth zone, you'll notice that there's an actual water effect. It looks kind of wavy, so that'll be a nice change of pace, too. And we are already done with the first act. I didn't really have to walk through that one very much. If you can't get past the first level, you'll never finish the game. So I just use that level as like a briefing. Alright, act two. Pretty much all the levels in Green Hill Zone is just go right. It's simple, and it should be. See, like, those spikes I just passed right there. If I were to hit those spikes, then land on another set of spikes, look at this, invincibility, what would happen is I would die, even though I'm supposed to be invincible after the first spike hit, because I'm flashing, but no, it doesn't work that way. Oops, oops, oh, not that way. Can I get up this way? Yeah, I can, okay. We're done! We are flying past this level! Oh, to answer any questions, the reason why I haven't played Sonic 1 just yet, I played 2, 3, and Sonic & Knuckles, up there's invincibility, and, because after playing 2 and 3 after playing 1, you gotta admit that 1 feels kinda broken without a spin dash. I mean, just think about it. If you've ever noticed, it's very difficult to climb hills sometimes in this game because of the physics that you don't have a spin dash. Whoa, didn't want that. Oops. Go, there we go. Keep going right, spin here, you can go right through the wall. And go on this platform, whoa, I missed it, but I'm safe. You can get some, I think it's rings here. Yep. And up here. Oh yeah, I got it. Invincibility. One thing I regretted in my Sonic 3 walkthrough was I didn't properly show you how to beat this boss. Basically, wait under here, wait for the ball to pass, then jump up and hit him. Go back under, wait for the ball to pass, jump up and hit him. Keep repeating until you hit him 8 times. Or you can just rush him. It's not that hard. He's the first boss. Whew! We are done with Green Hill Zone. Not so bad, eh? Next up is the Marble Zone. It's full of many more traps. As in, much harder than Green Hill Zone. Yeah, for the second level, it gets pretty hard. Wish me luck. Oh, and it's got lava! Yeah! And a lot of moving platforms and stuff. I mean, it's not really that hard. You can go in here and get some rings, but I'm not going to. Watch these things. When the back end touches the lava, they start on fire. You can just jump off them before that happens. Easy enough. I don't know why I'm getting that shield. It doesn't really help all that much. Stay with the rhythm. Don't let the pistons squish you. They look like pistons. I don't know what they really are. But they're, I don't know, powered by lava. See this block? Push it to the right onto this switch. That will make this spiky chandelier go up. Wait for it to completely move, and then you can go under. You don't want to rush it, because that would hurt. Hit the lamppost. If you want. Now watch this part. Go slowly but surely. because you do not know which blocks are coming down unless you have the game memorized. Now, from here on out, you gotta watch out for dropping spike chandeliers like that, because some of them can squish you and kill you. Not very fun. Like, watch out here, right there, okay. Oh, I missed it. I was close. Got it. You always have to go on this one and then jump to this one to get up there. And we are almost done with the first act. Oh, that was kind of weird. I didn't fall. We're done. Oh, and to people wondering, I'm not doing the bonus zones because of time restrictions on the camera and whatever. They're not that hard to get all the emeralds. So, experiment on your own. That's all I can say. Most people just want to know how to beat the game, not how to get all the emeralds and stuff like that. Hit this switch, that thing will move down. Whew. Yeah, push the blocks into the lava, and then the block will float across the lava slowly, and you'll be able to move. Look out for that. Go up here. There's a whole bunch of goodies with some enemies. Whew. Okay, watch out for this part. Your jumping must be precise, yet careful. Like, watch. There. Oops. Here's the spikes. Watch out for them. Okay. And there we go. We're past it. Yeah, that's like a lava trap. Oh, I thought there was a lamppost up there. That's okay. And just walk from one to the other. Don't jump. Jumping might upset your timing. It really is easier just to walk past these. These caterpillars just spin through. Whoa, no, no, no. That would have been bad. Okay, there's a shield up there, but I already got a shield. Okay, this part you absolutely have to watch the... I mean, you have to ride on the block. Some parts with these blocks you can jump over, but this one you absolutely have to. On the third lava eruption like that, you have to jump up on the platform a special way. Like, wait for the block to come down just a little bit. Like, right here, then jump. Otherwise, you'll hit the ceiling, and then you'll fall into the lava. Okay. Whew. There's a lamppost to the left of there, I think. But I'm not going to hit that, because we're close to the end. At least I think we are. Oh, maybe not. Oh, yeah, we are. Oh, wait, maybe not. You know, I just did a test run. I should have this memorized. Okay, go over here. Get the invincibility. Now you can just go right through the lava. Now you gotta wait here. But as for now, I'm gonna cut it off because we are at around 8 minutes. So I'll see you guys in the next part.